We are going to pray this afternoon, and we'll be reading from the scriptures. We've got quite a few. So the scriptures for today's prayer is from Psalms 150 verse 6, Romans 3:23, Luke chapter 4 verse 8, Mark chapter 11 verse 24, Philippians 4 verse 19. And we are going to knock on the heaven's door. The Lord is going to hear our prayer this day. We are breaking every limitation, all things that are hindering you. In the name of Jesus, the Lord is going to do great things as we come in His presence together. So I'll first start off by reading the book of Psalms. And Psalm 150 verse 6. And I'll read this from the New King James Version. And the Bible says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. And I'll be reading also from the book of Romans 3:23. And all the scriptures are going to be from the New King James Version. And the Bible says, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Amen. In the book of Luke, chapter 4, verse 8. And Jesus answered and said to him, get behind me, Satan, for it is written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him only you shall serve. Mark 11, 24. Therefore, I say to you, whatever things you ask when you pray, believe that you receive them and you will have them. Believe. Believe that you receive them and you will have them. Philippians chapter 4 verse 19. And my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. And my God shall supply all my need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Personalize these scriptures when you're about to pray. Declare it upon yourself, upon your life, upon you, upon your situations. And my God shall supply all my need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. This afternoon, we are going to pray and we are going to give God all the glory, all the honor that he deserves. We're going to thank him for all the things that he's doing for us and all the things that he's continuing to do. And we are going to lift him above all things. Because as we read in Psalms 150 verse 6, it says that let everything that has breath praise ye the Lord. Everything that has breath, including animals that has breath, praise ye the Lord. And he says that if we don't praise him, what will he do? He will cast the stones to worship him. And we don't want that, because to be alive is through his glory. To be alive is through his presence. To be alive is by his grace, because he has thought of you before you are alive. And so the only thing you can do to show some form of gratitude, to give praise to him, is to give him the fruit of your lips. So we have to give God all the praise. We have to give God all the honor. We have to give God all the adoration for our lives this day, for our strength, for our health. He says that in all things, give God thanks. In all things, whether good, whether bad, whether it makes sense to you or not. He says in all things, we should thank the Lord. How much more if you have a reason to thank the Lord because you are awake, because you are alive, because you're here today by his glory. We are going to pray this afternoon, and we're going to knock on the heaven's door, and we are going to give God all the thanks and all the praise. And we are going to let his spirit take over. And we're going to let the Lord do what he does best. He says that where his spirit is, there's freedom, there's liberty. There shouldn't be anything that is hindering you. And we are going to pray that at the end of today's prayer session, that everything that we have asked for, because we believe, we shall receive. Because we believe, we shall receive. Because we believe, we shall receive. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we come before you and we give you all the praise and adoration. Take all the glory this morning. Take all the glory this day. Take all the glory. Father, Lord, we worship you. Father, that we are alive today, it's not by might, it's not by power, by your Holy Spirit. For us to have breath, Lord, we bless your holy name. Lord, we thank you, Jesus, that you are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords. You are the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last, the God that was and is to come. There is none like you. Lord, we worship you and we exalt you above all things. We come before your throne of grace and we thank you. Lord, we join the elders and we say that indeed, Father, you are holy. We join the elders and we say that glory are you, Lord. We join the elders and we say you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lord. Jesus, the elders bow before you and they give you praise 24 hours. The elders come before you and they worship you at your throne. How much more us, Lord God, that is the living testimony of your word. Jesus, we say we bless you and we honor you. Lord God, we give you all the praise and adoration this day. Father, Lord, take all the glory, Lord. Jesus, we bless and we exalt you. Lord, we come before you and we say take all the glory. Lord, take all the praise. Lord, we worship and we praise you, for it is written that, Lord, we shall worship you. Lord, it is written that we should worship you and you only. And Lord God, we give you all the praise and worship this hour. Lord God, we say let your name be glorified. Lord God, we exalt you and we say that, Lord, you indeed, you are the Christ of God. You are the King of Kings. Lord God, I thank you for being who you are, for being true to yourself, for giving us life this day, for protecting us whilst we were sleeping. Lord God, we thank you, Lord, for your protection and for your blood. Jesus, we thank you for coming on the cross to die for our sins. Lord, we thank you in the name of Jesus, the Lord, we are redeemed and we are saved today because of your blood. We thank you that you went on the cross of Calvary and that we are saved. Jesus, take all the glory this afternoon. Lord, we worship you and we give you all the praise and adoration. Lord, we honor you. You said that if all men lift you up, Lord, you will draw us close to you. And so, Lord, we lift your name above all things. We lift your name above all circumstances. We lift your name above all things today. We say that, Lord, we lift your name on high. Jesus, take all the glory this day. Father, Lord, we come before you and you say that, Lord, for all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. You said that if we ask for forgiveness of sins, you are faithful and just to forgive us. Father, Lord, we come before you and we ask the Lord, you cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Anything that is impure, Lord, take it away from us. Wash us and let us be whiter than snow. Cleanse us and create a new spirit within us. We ask, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, the Lord, you look down upon us with your mercy, that anything that is that is on us, that is impure, any sin that we have committed against you, anything from our bloodline, anything from our friends, anything that is a familiar spirit, whatever it is that is tracing us down, that is causing confusion, that is being a hindrance to us, that is being a block to us, that is hindering our blessings from reaching us, anything that is before us, that is causing us for our prayers for not being answered, anything that is before us, that is causing sin before you, Jesus, we ask the Lord, you forgive us for our sins this day. Father Lord, we ask in the name of Jesus, the Lord, you forgive us our sins. Lord God, wash us with your blood. Father Lord, wash us with your blood. Jesus, cleanse us. Mendere yama seterebe. Menderebe seteria manderebe sete. Mendebe se anderia manderebe sete. Maseteria manderebe seteria mande. Mendebe se anderia manderebe sete. Mendebe se anderebe se anderia manderebe sete. Manderebe seteria manderebe. Mendebe se anderia mamanderebebe. Mendebe seteria baba manderebebe. You said that, Lord, you will. You shall supply all our need according to your riches in glory. He said that whatever we ask, Lord, we should believe and that we have received it. We should believe. And so, Lord, we are standing on your word today. And we believe that, Lord God, everything we're going to ask for today, Father, Lord, you shall supply us according to your riches in glory. Because we know that faith is the substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. So when you are praying and you believe, you've activated your faith. And your hope is that your prayers has been answered. And so the hope is the one thing that you cling on to. And you believe that indeed your prayers have been answered. And that no devil in hell can take what God has for you. When you pray, we decree 1,000 blessings upon our lives. The Lord God, you shine upon us. The Lord God, you answer our prayers this day. The Lord God, you hear our cry, O Lord. Father Lord, we pray and we come before you. Let the Holy Spirit intercede for you. Let the Holy Spirit ask for things that you do not even know of. Let the Holy Spirit, Lord, speak mysteries on my behalf. Let your Spirit, Lord God, take my request to your throne room. Let my request be known unto you, Jesus. Let my request be known unto you, Jesus. Father Lord, we ask you this day, the Lord, you order our steps, for the steps of the righteous are ordered by you. Jesus, order our steps. To all those that are viewing you, to all those that are listening, to all those that are tuning into this prayer session, Lord God, we come before you and we ask the Lord, you order our steps in anything pertaining our life. We ask you, Jesus, the Lord, you take control. For we cannot build without you not being a foundation. For anything we do that you're not based on. For anything we do that is not based on you. That is not based on your word. That is not based as you, as a foundation. If we don't lay you as a foundation, whatever we do it in vain. And so, Lord God, we lay you as our foundation. We lay you at our base. We say that, Lord God, decree a new thing. As you order our steps, Lord, let us walk into our destiny. As you order our steps, Lord, let us walk into our destiny. Help us. As you order our steps, Lord, break free of any shackles, break free of any yoke, break free of any limitation, break free. Mandere seteria manderebe sete. Manderea baba seterebebe seteria mama manderebe. Manderebe seteria mama manderea mas. Seterebe sete, mendebe se anderia mamanderebebe sete, mandebe se anderia bababa seterebebe, mendebe anderia mamama seterebebe, mendebe se anderia mamama seterebe. You know, in the book of Daniel, when the people turned against him to be put in a lion's den because he was praying to his God, the king was not even happy with that decision. The king was not even happy of the decree that he made, because it is Daniel that was going to be thrown in the lion's den. The king did not even eat. He could not sleep. Why? Because the person that he likes, the person that he trusts, whom he believes is not at fault, is being thrown into the lion's den. All those that have surrounded, all those that have gathered in your name, all those that have plotted things against you, all those that have said that you will not succeed, all those that sit there and plot evil in your name, they shall not be successful. They shall not succeed. He says that no weapon formed against me shall prosper. It doesn't say, he says that no weapon formed against me. So that means they will sit, they will gather, they will talk your name, they will discuss things about you, but it shall not prosper. Why? Because the Lord sits at the throne of his mercy. The Lord sits at his throne in his great room. The Lord sits at his throne in his glory, and he shall not watch his children go and beg for bread. He shall not watch his name be disgraced. He shall not watch his name be ashamed, because when we pray in the name of Jesus. And so the Lord has every right to defend himself. And so this day, we said that anyone that is plotting anything against us, Father Lord God, you said that the king could not sleep. And when he woke up, he shouted Daniel, and Daniel responded. And what did Daniel say? That because you, God, did not find fault in him, and you know that he's innocent, you did not allow the lions to eat him, and you shut their mouth, and the king was happy, and he said to come out. And then all those that accused Daniel falsely was thrown in the lion's den with their family, and they even got devoured before they even reached the bottom of that den. And so this hour, the Lord God is going to sit in for you. The Lord God is going to shut the mouth of the lion. The Lord God is going to shut any mouth of your enemy. And he says that what? He shall protect you. He shall guide you. He shall lead you. You shall come out freely. And the person they used to plan things against you as their point of contact, that same person will have sleepless nights. That same person will go hungry until you are set free. And so that applies to your destiny helpers. Those that the Lord has called to be your destiny helper, the Lord will give them sleepless nights. The Lord will cause them not to sleep. The Lord will cause them not to eat until they meet you. So in this day, decree a blessing upon yourself, that as the Lord is ordering your step, he shall give you what is rightfully yours. He shall give you what is rightfully yours. He shall give you a blessing that is upon you. He shall give you the Abrahamic blessing upon your life. And when it is all said and done, the glory belongs to him. Everything that we do is for the glory of the Lord. Everything that we say is for the glory of the Lord. Everything that we partake in is for the glory of the Lord. And we must learn to come before your throne of grace, Jesus. Lord, we humble ourselves before you. And we say, Lord God, decree a new thing. But Lord, we say that, Lord, bless us this day. Jesus, we come before you and we say that, Lord, shut the mouth of the lion, shut the mouths of the enemy, shut the mouths of our demons that is trembling us. And we say that anything that is formed against us shall not prosper, because Lord, we stand in your name, because your blood has already conquered the enemy, because you went on that cross and you took back the keys. You gave us back our dominion. You gave us back our authority. You gave us back our blessings. You gave us back what is rightfully ours. And so today, anything that the Lord said concerning you, this hour shall be manifested. If only you will believe in him and accept him in your life and say that indeed, Jesus Christ, you are Lord. Father Lord, be the pilot. Father Lord, be my leader. He says in Psalms 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord has to be your shepherd in order for you not to want. The Lord has to be your forefront. The Lord has to be everything. Everything about you has to be based on the Lord. Everything around you has to be before the Lord, because he's the only one that can move you in green pastures. He's the only one that can prepare a table before you in the presence of the enemies. Why? Because he's your shepherd. Your shepherd has to look after you. Your shepherd has to make sure you do not lack. Your shepherd has to make sure that he provides everything for you. And so, Lord, as you are our shepherd this day, Father Lord, we say that, Lord, let your will be done in our life. Father Lord, we say that, let your will be done in our lives. We say that, Lord, let your will be done in our lives. Father Lord, we pray and we commit all those that are watching in your hands, those that are online, those that are listening to you. Father Lord, we commit them in your hands. And Jesus, we say, take control. All those that are troubled in their spirits, all those that are in their wilderness moments, all those that are going through the wilderness and do not see you in the midst of their storm, Jesus, give them strength. Just ask, Lord, you knelt down in the garden. Lord, you cried till you cried blood. And the angel of the Lord came to strengthen you. Father, Lord, for all those that are weak, give them that strength. For all those that are wanting to give up, Lord, give them that strength. Give them your visitation, O Lord. Give them an angelic visitation, O Lord. And let your angel strengthen them. Let your angel strengthen them. Let your angel strengthen them in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, it is not over until you win. You have never lost a battle, and you're not going to start now. And Lord, we believe in you, and we thank you, Lord, for answering prayers. And we bless your holy name, Jesus, for all the things that you keep doing in our lives. We thank you, Lord, for your spirit. We thank you, Lord, for your Holy Spirit. We exalt and we lift your name above all things. Lord, we thank you for the lives of those that are watching. Jesus, we bless you for those that are watching. We thank you for their lives. Continue to be their rock. Continue to be their shield and buckler. And continue to shut the mouth of their enemies. And cause them, Lord, to put you first. Anyone who is losing faith, all we need is faith as little as a mustard seed. As little as a mustard seed. And we can move mountains with it. Strengthen them, O Lord, and give them that faith. Speak to those that are wanting to hear you. Let your will be done in everyone's life this day. In all those that are watching, may the Lord lead you and guide you. Let the Holy Spirit take control of your life. Let your flesh be subdued and let his spirit take over. Let him order every step of your life. And I pray in the name of Jesus that the Lord will do what he does best. The Lord will answer you. The Lord will give you strength. The Lord will show himself to you in a mysterious way. I pray that some of you may have encounters that you need. And I pray that the Lord will forever be your Savior. Your Savior, your Savior. Let the Lord lead you in everything that you do. And you shan't fail. And you shan't fall. Your setback is not the end of your journey. It's how you view it. At times, our setback is our success, depending on how we learn from it. Or depending if we how we speak to God to find out what it is that God is saying in the midst of this wilderness, in the midst of this storm, and the Lord shall speak to you. Father, Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for answered prayers, and we bless your holy name. In the name of Jesus Christ, do we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. For those that have been online, may the Lord richly bless you. For those that are watching, may the Lord richly bless you. And you can go through the scriptures. Encourage yourself. Encourage yourself. Encourage yourself. When things are not going so great, encourage yourself. We have to learn to walk in the boldness that he has given unto us. He says that we should come before him boldly. Boldly. For he has not given us a spirit of fear. And you have to trust in the Lord. You have to trust in the Lord. And all is well. All is well. I believe all is well. And the Lord shall continue to show forth himself and his power. And we shall all be a testimony unto his name. In Jesus' name. Until then, stay blessed. Until next time, remain true in the word of the Lord. Amen. Bye, guys.